Hey there, Biz414 here, back with another episode of Steam Bin, and today I'm going to play a little bit of Overture. Now, this is a game that I've played quite a bit recently, ever since I got it. I've been playing it here and there when I've got some free time. It's a really fun roguelike, kind of dungeon crawler. It's a multi-directional shooter kind of play style. There's a lot of those on the market, but this was a lot of fun. It's got this really nice little pixelated style, and plenty of characters. You've got warriors, and when you first start out, you just have this guy, and then you purchase all these other guys for 2,000 monies each, which I've already done. I've played each of these characters a little bit. I think out of the warriors, my favorites were was pretty cool, I believe. Brute was pretty cool. Because they have different abilities. Each one's, they have a primary attack, a secondary attack. Each one is a little bit different. This is the main ranger. The ranger is the main rogue, I mean. And then we've got bandit, trickster, thief, duelist. I think out of these, I really liked the duelist and the trickster, if I remember correctly. Shamans are pretty cool. You start out with cleric, and then you unlock priestess, paladin, monk, justicar, druid. All of these were pretty fun. They're kind of magic users. My favorite, of course, though, is the mages. You start out with just a standard wizard, which is pretty fun. And then there's a witch, an invoker. He turns into a monster, which is neat. So does the druid. He turns into a wolf. Warlock is one of my favorites. The necromancer is really cool. He spawns skeletons. The arsonist is fun. Let's go ahead and be an arsonist. And you can upgrade these guys with money, which I wish it said how much the upgrade was. It doesn't say how much it's going to cost me to do the next level. So let's see. Going from tier 5 to tier 6. Went from 6,000 to 3,500, so 2,500. Not too bad. And that basically just increases my attack level. As you're playing, you increase your player's level. And that increases some of your stats, I believe. Now you control it with the left stick moves you, right stick controls this little reticle. And you can use the mouse and keyboard as well, but I like the controller better. Seems a lot faster. Right trigger is your main attack. Left trigger is like a secondary attack. Main attack doesn't use mana or anything. Secondary attack uses mana. My little blue bar. Sprinting, you just stop shooting and push towards your reticle. As you saw, those little crates right there, those are NPCs that I can rescue that will then help me in combat. Ooh, lots of enemies. They drop loot, of course, all kinds of gold and pennies. They drop the blue potions, which are mana. They drop red potions, which are health, pretty standard. Then they also have power-ups. So you see in the top right, all those little icons. Oh, that means traps. Uh-oh, I died. I was going to say, all those little squares on the top right show like five different types of power up you can get, like gear. So then I got to level 2 and I died on the first floor. I didn't do good. I'm usually better. Let's try, just because I showed what this guy does, mostly just lots and lots of fire. Let's check out the warlock. Another fave. Let's upgrade him one more since I've got the money to do it. Alright. Here we go. Oh, and also, as you point out, hit start. It shows you some character info. Mostly I go here just to find out what their powers are. You see this third from the top, that's your primary. The expanding fireball, red cloud when HP is less than 40%. And then the other one, fourth down, a red cloud of death and events, fireball. That's my right trigger, my special. I believe that's out. Oh no, opposite that. Fourth from the top was the L trigger. For this guy, that's what it does. It drops a little like a ball that just sits there and shoots after I've walked away. It's pretty handy. Like for boss fights, you can just place a whole bunch of them around the boss and just kind of like focus on evading. It's pretty handy. Like right now, I can just like place a bunch of these and just run around, evade. They'll do the work. I can just pick up treats. It's nice. Ooh, treasure chest. Kinds of gold. The gold doesn't despawn. The items like that, they don't despawn. But any boss character out. Let's pick that up. But the potions do despawn. Okay, there we go. Get those guys. The shield. Do that. Let's shoot some of these fools. There's a sword that adds 40 attack damage. Now this, none of that stuff, none of these pickups are aesthetic, like they don't change the way I look or anything. It just increases my stats. So if I go here, using equipment, plus 90 attack for the weapon, plus 100% chance to do DO damage. I imagine that's double damage. Then my shield gives me plus 3 defense, shirt gives me plus 2 defense. Then I've got those other two magic items. Pretty cool. Really fun game. Lots of depth to it as far as power-ups and stuff. I haven't made it very far. To be honest, I've only made it to, I think, the third floor of the dungeons. Okay, this is a boss down there shooting all that garbage at me. I'm going to run away from him a little bit and see if I can get some more items to power up before we fight him. To help me. Or die trying. The slowdown lag effect. There's little named enemies like this guy that are way more durable. And then, what's this? Why is that? Put it up. Break it. Don't do anything. Oh, those little rings, those are traps. These guys right here drop all kinds of goodies, but then they spawn a whole bunch of bad guys as well, so watch out for that. I really love the particle effects in this. Pretty. Really good visuals, nice music. Gameplay's also, gameplay's also pretty solid. Get off me, bat. Didn't see him. Now see, like, now that my health is really low, look how crazy this attack is. Look at all those particles. And I do so much damage now. Let's go down here and attack the bad guy a little bit. Oh, I still got this. We gotta be careful, though, because my health is low. That's already been saved. Oh, I've just got some health. No more craziness. Crazy power-up shooting. Ow. I want this treasure chest. Ow. Okay, I'm gonna drop some of these around him. Yo. Watch out. Oh, I'm out of mana. I want that shield. Okay, I don't want it that bad. Let's try and go through those. Not looking too hot. I need to go find some help. Let's get away from this guy. Go over here. See if there's any chests or power-ups that I haven't gotten yet. Sometimes there's stuff hidden underneath these little black boxy things. Whoa. Leveled up. That gave me some health. Brilliant. Oh, we got little swords. Sword stands over there. Let's check out the sword stand. Better than what I have. Little XP book. Ooh. Poison gas came from that urn, which damages the enemies. Sometimes they also explode. Sometimes the urns just have money in them. Ow, ow! That hurt me. Wasn't paying attention. Ow! Dump all those in there. That. See what I mean? I can just drop those off and run away. Hey guys, he's dead now. Any loot that I want? Nothing. And then we just go in here, and then we're gonna have another. Like, that wasn't apparently the boss. The actual boss is next. Ready? Goodness. Big giant spider thing. On dimes. Nope. Run away. Ow. 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 Yeah, they're tough. The bosses are tough. It's a lot better to go into the boss fight when you have plenty of NPCs to back you up and stuff, which I did not have. Let's go ahead and try a different class. Should we do shamans? Let's do this guy. I liked this guy. I got pretty far with him. Let's upgrade him. There we go. Right, playing as the shaman class druid. Look, he is a mystical druid. He has increased defense and speed while in wolf form. He fires a magical missile for his R trigger. He transforms into a wolf with a decaying speed boost with his left trigger. So, basically, it's kind of like a dual purpose kind of character, where in normal mode, I'll demonstrate. I fire missiles, ranged character, but then if I press left trigger, I'm a wolf, and I'm a melee character, so I have a much shorter range, but I'm quite quick at first. Over time, that speed boost slows down, but he seems to be quite durable in wolf form. I still do take damage, but not as quickly as I do in druid. As you see, I'm getting quite slow now, not as fast as I was when I first started. Take care of this green blobby guy, and then if I hit left trigger, I turn back into a druid. Ow, wait. Do some shooting. Take care of these rats. Power up. Take care of this tree guy, too. Power up. And then when I'm ready, or if I get into a pickle, I can always go back into my wolf form again and really kind of mess stuff up again. Like right now, get out of there. Get to the edge of where the traps are. When that happens, that's the best strategy. Oh, you don't get surrounded. No. And then it makes it easy to make quick work of them. This character, this class is pretty awesome. Maybe a little OP, but it's pretty awesome. I like playing as it. Oh, starting to slow down. I'm gonna go back into this mode for a minute. Oh, green arrow means the boss or mini boss, mid-level boss, whatever you want to call it, has appeared. See on our team. So many enemies on screen. At once in this game. Ooh, experience point. And I've also got, the druid also seems to have this, animals with him. Like, I've got that bird that follows me. Every once in a while, I'll see a wolf. So, like, see that shadow wolf right there? I don't know what he's doing, but I'm pretty sure he's helping. Watch out for the trap. Oh. No worries. Just turn into a wolf. Everything's fine. variety of enemies in this as well. That's a good one. Let's get away from him for a minute, fellas. Let's get all the goodies before we fight him. All the goodies. I've already got all the character classes unlocked, but I don't have, you know, have them all leveled up all the way. There's still quite a bit of grinding to do, and as I said, I haven't really made it very far in the game yet. I need to like level 3. I don't know if this is like unlimited levels or if there's a point where the game ends. No idea. I think that's already been sprung, yeah. Let's go down here. Let's work our way down to this corner. Yeah. Jerks. Get poisoned. That's a terrible sword. Ow. This wolf form just messes everybody up. Terrible. You know, it doesn't even matter. I walk right into him. Like I said, maybe just a little open. Another NPC. I got like, how many NPCs do I have now? Four? Three or four? I'm gonna turn back into druid mode. Just for a minute, so that when I go to engage the boss, I can have my speed boost again. Now that wolf seems to be like going and holding the enemies. Pretty awesome. Nice shield. And that. Another NPC. Another one. There's another one over here. Yep. We are so strong now. Oh my. Still don't want to just like walk into the onslaught of projectiles though. Still gotta be a little careful. Run away, guys. Trying to protect them. They have their own health bars, and they don't seem to heal. They just kind of are fodder. Uh-oh. Just bring that trap. This spear is better than what I currently have. I wish that my guys would get the health potions that I don't need. That would be handy. Ooh, that was better than what I have. Let's take that. Ow! I have another NPC. More weapons. Ow. They're not better than what I have. Alright, I'm gonna try and get in close to this guy. Gotta really watch my health up here. Ow. Ow, ow. Alright, I seem to be doing okay on health. Helpers seem to be doing halfway decent as well. Okay. We win. Let's go up here and grab all these pennies and then go on to the boss. Looking in much better shape for the boss this time. Alright. Here we go. Who do we fight this time? Grim Reaper guy. Sweet. Run away. Spawn so many enemies. Oh my gosh, you killed all my friends. Killed all my friends. I'm all alone now and you have all kinds of friends. Not fair. Not fair at all. Alright. And then at the end of the boss battle, you pick health or mana. I usually pick health. Mana doesn't generally seem to be a huge problem. you could probably walk past these and not unlock them, but I always do just to see what they are. Sometimes you get better stuff, sometimes not. And on we go to floor number 2. Usually my strategy is to push to one side of the map or one corner of the map and then work my way around the circle until I get all the loots or until I feel like attacking the boss, whichever comes first, or until I die again, whichever comes first. Alright, come on. To the right side, I'm just going to work my way clockwise here, around the map, that's pretty good, no, spirit hook. I love all of the damage numbers on screen, it's awesome. Again, love the particle effects and animations for this. I don't trigger that trap. Oh, triggered that trap though. Ow, ow. What's this? Nothing good. Thanks for the help, doggy person thing. And bird thing.
Mess you up. Dog move.
I'm glad my little buddies can't trigger the traps, just me. Barrels. Look at the dragon. Kill the dragon! Found any NPCs, I'm surprised. Now, the maps are pretty big, so doing that, you still miss on some of the middle. Oops, I didn't want to search for that. So you do have to kind of cut through the middle a little bit, usually. That's okay. You cover a large portion of it going about it like this. These goblins really try to circle around to your back. A quill that angered. Oh my god, look how much health you guys have. Jeez. And I want. I like how his shots are like rainbow, where each one is like a different color. Uh-oh, traps. Don't get your friends killed right away. Ow. Starting to get some pretty gear now. Ow. Ow. So I can get my speed boost, and I'm gonna go mess up this boss. I hope. Ow. Oh, what is that? Uh-oh. There's a lot of traps. Get out of here, jerks. Oh my. There's a lot of named enemies. Die! Die, 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 please die. Finally. Another trap. Seriously. I'm paying attention to where I'm going. Alright, I wanna go see what this big trap over here was. Ow! Ow, ow! Ow! Oh my god, I'm hitting like every trap that there is. Look at all these guys. At least I can just like rip through them, I guess. Get out of here. Don't hit that trap. We don't need any more guys. I need another trap. I seriously can't, like, see them underneath the balls of the loot and stuff. Screw you guys. Let's go fight the boss. Get out of here. Leave me alone. Trap right there. I see that one. At him. Ow. Ow, ow, ow. 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 Down we go. Crab thing. Sand King Crab. Jump the fire. At least I'm full health starting out at this boss battle. I thought I was going to start out with the lowered health I had from the last boss fight.
Get him. Get him. Ow. Ow, ow.
Health. I need the health, I need the health.
Run away. Yeah, 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 yeah. Ow. Get him. Help.
Ooh. Nice. I'll get the health upgrade again. Oh, 100 attack plus chance of dropping an HP potion on hit. That's pretty good. Why is that better? 7 defense is better. Good. That's not better. That's not better. Alright. Here we go. Floor 3. Alright. I think this will be the last floor, whether I beat it or not. I'm running out of time here. I've got to get going on some other things. If I can find the boss quickly, he will engage. Oh, what is this guy? I believe that the way he fights is if I get outside of the circle. Did that hurt me? No? I thought he did something where, like, his circle hurt me or something. I don't know. I think I fought this guy before. He's not a boss, he's just... that. I'm gonna just zip around and see if I can find any loot. Exploding barrel. Look at the traps just appearing. Yeah, here. Oh, Minotaurs. Minotaurs. Ow! Minotaurs are tough, man. Well, that's going to be it for me for this episode of Steam Bin. Pretty great game, Overture. I really like it. It's a really fun dungeon crawler. If you're into multi-directional shooters or roguelikes, It's a pretty good one. I picked it up for cheap on sale on Humble Bundle, I believe, a few days back or a week ago or so. But I believe regular price is like $10, so still not a bad deal. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to leave a like if you did, and I'll see you next time.